Hello friends, you are again welcome to Laptex, and today we are going to discuss about the settings that are required to be done for a DSO so that it can be used very effectively for laptop repairing and for any signal measurement. What are the basic settings that we require? We'll see and we'll go through that in this. Let's restart this. First, we will go through the threshold level settings that whenever there is a basic setting that is required in a DSO. So in the first setting, we will use the utility specification of the DSO where the basic setting is required to be done. Then you will get to see on the right corner of the screen different pages that are appearing on the screen, and you have F1, F2, F3, F4, F5 switches that are used to access those pages. Then you can see the options, and there will be a reset option that will be used to reset this DSO to its factory setting, as we do in our mobiles also. So this will reset itself to the factory setting. Let me show you this again. We'll go to the utility again, and then we'll travel through the pages, and when you reach the reset option, there you have to reset it. Reset option, there you have to reset it and then execute it so that it will reset itself to the original factory settings. Now let's see. Let me tell you one of the important points. You can see here there is a square wave pin and a ground pin, and you have two settings in the probe, that is a 1x setting and a 10x setting. Now on going to channel 1 setting, you can see we can select a probe as x1 and x2, and after that put that probe on the square wave point and then press auto. You will get the square wave, perfect square wave signal of 1 kilohertz that is used for the calibration of this DSO, because when you are using it for measuring any signal, then you must first calibrate it. That's why we are doing its calibration using this technique. So what you have to do, you have to do just two things. Put the negative probe or you can say the negative tongue in the ground position, and put the probe in the square wave position that you can see here, and then just press auto. You will get your channel calibrated that is ready to use for measuring any signals that you want to measure. Now fine, let's see another point. We'll see what are the points and the settings that we need before we get into the work and we get into the deep usage of this DSO. One of the most important point in this is this trigger level. This trigger level is used when you are capturing any signal. Say you have a very microsecond signal that you want to capture and analyze it, that it is working well or not, then you have to use this trigger point. We'll discuss later when we use the capture mode. Now let's see how it will be used to see the variation of a crystal behavior. Right now I'm using a board, motherboard, and I'm trying to check the crystal without having any trigger point level setting or any other further setting of DSO. I'm going to check the RTC section of the motherboard, that is the crystal section. But you can see from DSO that there is no any sinusoidal variation on the display. So you have to do some settings to get the readings correct. Channel 1. And then we'll see the options appearing on the right corner of the screen, and there is a coupling option. You have to change the coupling from the DC to the AC, because you are measuring the AC signal that is having frequency, so you have to change the coupling from DC to AC. Now we'll do a further setting and check whether the signal is appearing or not. As you can see, there is the signal is not appearing properly because it might be a very larger value signal. So we'll change the probe setting from X1 to 10X. You can go through the channel and see the probe setting. It is 1X, 10X, 100X and 1000X. But we in the probe, we have available only two settings, that is 1X and 10X. So I'm setting it to 10X. Now we'll see a bit of setting in the acquire, and there is a mode setting where we have to change from sample to the average, so that we can get a very sampled the average of the sample signal, and now let's check whether we get the signal or not. So now you can see we are getting a perfect sinusoidal signal that is appearing in the RTC section, and you can see from the measure button that in channel 1 frequency you can see 32.78 kilohertz frequency is showing on the screen. So the two settings that are required to be done is you have to go to channel 1, then go for decoupling from DC to the AC and change the acquire setting from sample to the average. Now you'll see on the practical motherboard, you can see this is the crystal region of the RTC section, and I'm checking in the input section as well as the output section. As you know, input is also sinusoidal and output is also sinusoidal, but there is a difference between the shape. So you can see the power is on, and I have not turned on the motherboard, but just I am checking the input and the output signal.